So today with the update, Activision decided to give everybody a free Mark II weapon with their new weapon crate that they decided to add. Oh yeah, and did I mention there's a $30 melee weapon bundle? I got a lot of things that I gotta say about this. But before we do that, I want to let you know that today's video is sponsored by World of Warships Blitz. This is a free-to-play mobile game available on both the App Store and Google Play, and you can find both links down below in the description where you can download it absolutely free. One thing I can truly respect is the warships that are available. There are dozens of warships that are historically authentic, and the best part is, you can control every single one of them in some epic multiplayer battles against other people online. And since the game is being updated all the time, that means new ships are coming all the time. Recently on March 20th, the German destroyers made their way into the game, and even though they might have weaker armor, they have really good maneuverability and speed, fast reloading torpedoes, and some pretty decent guns with good fire range. To date, the German destroyers are the smallest warships in World of Warships Blitz. Don't let that small size fool you, it packs a very powerful punch and will make short work of any unsuspecting enemy that enters your territory. Once again, big thank you to World of Warships Blitz for sponsoring today's video. This game is absolutely free to play and you can find a link down below in the description. It's available right now on the App Store and Google Play. I find it really ironic that the ad read that I did today for World of Warships Blitz fell right on this specific update. And I find it even more funny that you can find more free content in World of Warships Blitz than you can in Call of Duty Black Ops 4. It pains me to say that. We're gonna start this conversation off by talking about the Demo Hammer, which is the new melee weapon that was added today that costs close to $30. I am not kidding when I say that. This is not a Photoshop. This is what it is right now on the PlayStation 4. If you were to go buy COD points to get this exact number, it would cost you a total of $24. But then you're losing out on value, because really what they want you to do is spend $40 to get the 5,000 COD points. That way you get better value and you could still get the Demo Hammer. You know, one thing that I don't understand, and it's probably the most bald-headed idea I ever seen, if you look at the live stream that we just got yesterday with David Von der Haar and the Treyarch team, you can see that he's showing off the Demo Hammer, making it out to be this really cool thing, and it makes a nice big explosion when you hit somebody with it, and he mentioned that it's just cosmetic only. Even if it's just cosmetic only, why in the world would anybody at that studio, at Activision, whoever makes these decisions, who thought that was a good idea? These things are not valued for everybody, because some of you may see the value in the bundles, some of you may see value in the tier skips, and okay, I get that. But I don't see value in that at all, especially if you grind the actual crap out of this game. Even after opening the three new Mark II weapons that were added today to the reserves, and of course there's an outfit too, I still have over 350 drops left. So where some people may see the value of the bundle, I don't. I wish this was all parted out. I wish that the hammer itself was available by itself for $1.99 or $2.99 or hell, even $4.99. And since it is just a cosmetic change, no one would be mad about that. At least I don't think anyone would be mad about that. But I do agree with a lot of the people in the community. Where's the bonuses for the Black Ops Pass? Like, if you spend $50 on the Black Ops Pass, I think you should automatically get access to the new weapons that are added. I don't think you should have to go to tier 100 to get all the weapons. I also think that every single melee weapon that's added to the game should be given to you for free as well, because you spent the money previously to get the Black Ops Pass, which is now feeling like a big scam to a lot of people. This is the type of stuff that scares me for the future. Because if we thought that Black Ops was a cash cow, wait until they bring back the Modern Warfare series. I'm not kidding you when I say this either. I'm actually genuinely concerned. The Modern Warfare series has been laying dormant for many years now. People have been waiting for a continuation of that. I cannot imagine how many nostalgia strings Activision's going to pull when it comes to their microtransactions in that game. And I am genuinely concerned. Anyway, let's move on away from this. I'm sure I'll have an update video talking about this hammer at some point, but let's move on with our lives and talk about the addition of the three new Mark II weapons. So the first weapon is the Mark II Cordite, which you've been seeing me use throughout this gameplay right here. It's like a pink and a blue. It looks really cool. The Mark II weapons always have a really nice look to them. And if you got your free Mark II drop today, you may have gotten lucky and ended up getting this Mark II Cordite, which I think is one of my favorites just because of the color scheme. Mark II weapons have this distinctive glow to them, and they have some really bright and poppy colors. The next weapon that was added is a Mark II Rampart 17. This is that bumblebee finish that we were talking about before, where it's like yellow on black, and then the light feature that it has is a green hue, and it looks really nice. All of these weapons share a common theme of like carbon fiber, so it all comes together really nice to look good not only in-game, but also when you weapon inspect. The final Mark II weapon that was added today is the Koshka Mark II. This thing looks absolutely beautiful. It's got this blue LED glow around it. The barrel itself is glowing, and then in the area where you replace your magazine, that's glowing too. It's got a nice metallic blue to it. It's just a really good looking weapon, and I really like this variant. Even though I don't use the Koshka much anymore, especially in multiplayer, it's nice to know that these variants are still usable in Zombies and Blackout, because it'll definitely get used there. Now finally, for new items that were added today, we had a brand new outfit added for Crash. It's called the Snitch, and this is what it looks like. It makes Crash look completely different. I honestly really like this outfit. I think it's nice. It's coming a little bit late in the Operation Grand Heist operation, but still it's here and it looks pretty cool. One big thing that I forgot to mention in yesterday's video, which a lot of people have been asking for, including myself, if you have reactive camos that you've been wanting to use on your weapons, but you don't feel like grinding gold camo, good news, you don't have to grind gold camo anymore. Reactive camo's been unlocked for every single gun, no matter if you have gold or not. So if you were in the process of unlocking it, you can stop now if you don't want to anymore. If you didn't want to collect those paint cans and blackout anymore, you are able to use reactive camos on every single gun. And this definitely gets a thumbs up for me, because now I don't have to waste my time running around collecting paint cans just to use some cool camos on my guns in Blackout. Moving on, the Bare Bones playlist was officially added today, so if anyone wants to play multiplayer without specialists, you can do that now in a mosh pit dedicated to that, which features team deathmatch and domination. I'll be honest with you guys, I went in to get some footage, and I could not hang, and that's because people were playing like it was the CWL qualifiers. I absolutely hated every single minute of it, and I'll definitely have to come back and try to figure that out at another time, because it was just not fun at all. To be honest, I don't really know what to think about multiplayer in this game anymore. I played it religiously for the first month and a half, 2 months, got Master Prestige, did my Dark Matter challenges, and I was playing just fine, and I can still play just fine to this very day, but it just doesn't feel enjoyable. I just don't enjoy my time in there. I don't know what it is. I have way more fun playing Zombies, way more fun playing Blackout. It just feels weird this year. Multiplayer has definitely been on the back burner for me for a very long time, and I don't know why. I'm gonna have a video coming up in the next couple of days, and it takes a more serious tone about the Call of Duty franchise as a whole. And I want to talk about that and my experiences with this game, and there's just a lot that I need to talk about, so hopefully you can join me for that video. Honestly, there's not much more I want to talk about with this specific update, because it just brought more controversy, and I'm sick of being depressed about a game that I used to absolutely admire. So, with that said, guys, I hope you all enjoyed today's video. If you did, drop a like on it, subscribe for more videos coming each and every day. If you're new to the channel and you haven't yet, don't forget to join the notification squad by clicking that little bell icon next to the subscribe button. And once again, big thank you to World of Warships Blitz for sponsoring today's video. Have a good one, guys. Peace.